Georgia College Television presents Central Georgia Tonight, a weekly news program written and produced by Georgia College journalism students. This quarter, Jeff Dawson, Dana Almers, Kevin Wilkins, Tyrone Lowe, Kitty Brent, Steve Norris, Don Pollard, Chris Bonanno, Mike Bell, and Tom Connor will bring you the latest news from Milledgeville, Macon, Dublin, and Warner Robins. And then stay tuned for Professor's Forum. Your host, Connie Book, will present issues and ideas with Georgia College faculty and staff. Stay tuned. Central Georgia Tonight is next.
Straight ahead on Central Georgia Tonight, the Piggly Wiggly on North Columbia gets a facelift.
Coming up next, there's a new pig in town. I'm Tom Connor.
And Georgia College baseball is in full swing. Then we're off to take a look at aviation past and present. Stay with us.
Finding a college where you really fit in can be tough. But at Georgia College, we make that choice easy with Sneak Preview Saturdays. Every weekend, students come check out our beautiful campus, see our long list of majors, and compare notes with some of the friendliest students in Georgia. So, if you're really worried about finding a college that wears well, call this number and say you want to come to Sneak Preview Saturday. All it takes is one visit to know where you belong.
A Milledgeville Piggly Wiggly closed its old store and opened a new one last week. Central Georgia Tonight's Tom Connor has the story. Tom?
Thanks, Steve. Shoppers rushed to the grand opening of the new Piggly Wiggly on North Columbia Street. Lines were long as shoppers scrambled to grab grand opening bargains.
The grand opening of the Piggly Wiggly on 441 North attracted regular customers of other stores last week. Rose Blizzard, a regular customer of the Piggly Wiggly on South Jefferson Street, says she stopped by to take a look at the new store and to hunt for grand opening bargains.
I liked all the plants and the cut flowers they had. The deli is very nice, but of course they've had that all along.
Blizzard likes the new store, but says she will continue to shop at the Piggly Wiggly on the south side of town.
It's convenient to me. I work on the south side of town, so the Piggly Wiggly out that way is very convenient.
The store is double the size of the old store and features a floral department. Store manager Steve Johnson says he has increased the number of employees from 49 to 129. Piggly Wiggly produce man Kelly Patrick says he worked overtime during the grand opening.
Well, I worked at that store right there. I started it about June 5th of 1992. And this grand opening, man, it's just hectic.
Patrick was promoted from bag boy to produce man during the grand opening. Store manager Steve Johnson says he expects the business boom to level off in a few weeks.
The crowds have subsided somewhat, but last week this parking lot was jam-packed for the grand opening.
Johnson hopes the store's features and appearance draw several new loyal customers.
That's just one of many new businesses opening on North Columbia Street right now. Steve?
Thanks, Tom. A Georgia College tradition has competition. Old-time student bar, the Opera House, is facing a challenge. A new bar opened in downtown Milledgeville earlier this month. Cameron's Bar, owned by Milledgeville resident and former Georgia College student Scott Cameron, is vying for student spending money. The bar is open 6 days a week to anyone 18 older and older until 2 a.m. Cameron plans to open an extra floor in the near future. Enrollment figures for spring quarter at Georgia College remain steady. This quarter, just over 5,000 students decided to return for classes. Georgia College had seen a 4% increase in enrollment during the fall and winter. This is the first quarter those figures have leveled off. A lit match is being blamed for a fire in Georgia College's residence hall, Napier. Public safety says a match that wasn't quite put out was dropped in the trash chute. The fire department responded quickly and damage was kept to a minimal. Students at Georgia College are planning a celebration on Earth Day on April 22nd. Residence Life is having a program complete with live music. Plans include educational materials from environmental groups on how you can make a difference in the Earth's future. Next on Central Georgia Tonight, Georgia College students take to the softball diamond and Braves fans get into the spirit of the season. Sports highlights when we return. Stay with us.
Well, this is just great. I can't believe every time you take the car, you leave the tank empty.
And if it weren't for your shortcuts, we'd be near a gas station by now.
Care to join me for a country stroll to a gas station?
No shortcuts?
When a day starts out wrong, that's not how it has to end. 'Cause the light in your eye reminds me why I'm glad you're my best friend. How can I stay mad for long? The smile's up around the bend. I don't know what I'd do if I didn't have you. Thanks for being my best friend. Thanks for being my best friend.
You folks care for a ride or something?
You wouldn't happen to have an umbrella, would you?
Best friends make the best marriages. From the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints.
That's my dad. And that's Mom. Dad's got an idea, a way to get rid of all the grody garbage that's polluting the world. He's invented a big rocket ship to shoot all the garbage into outer space. Mom's not sure, but Dad says his invention will save the world.
There's an easier way to save the world. Recycle for your free recycling action guide, right? Recycle, Environmental Defense Fund, 257 Park Avenue South, New York, New York.
You might want to check out Hatcher Square Mall this weekend. Professional gardeners will be showing off Central Georgia's best irises, and former Georgia Military College graduates can see old classmates this weekend during alumni activities. But now, Chris Bonanno joins us with sports. Chris?
Thanks, Steve. Intramural softball swung into action this month. Intramural Director Ron Murchison gives us information on the season.
We have 22 men teams and 10 women teams. In the men divisions, we have it divided up into four different divisions. And we will have a 22-team double elimination tournament at the end of the season to determine who will go to Atlanta, Georgia, representing GC.
Let's go to the men's softball standings. In the points leagues, the Pikes, the Kappa Sigs, and the Kappa Alphas all in first place, with the Pi Caps, Phi Delts, BSU lost their first two games. All right, let's go to the Eastern Division. Kappa Alpha 2 and Triple Crown with Hit Squad and Beeson Sanford rounding out the bottom of the list there. All right, let's go on. And to the Central Division, Hitmen and Goodfellas. Hitmen in first place, Goodfellas 1-1. Rastafarians 0-1, and Clinch Bunch and Desperados yet to play. All right, let's go on to the Western Division. Bad Company and Saloon Platoon in first place with 1-0. Hit and Run, Unforgiven 0-1, and Chubbs and Beavers yet to play. Okay, let's go over to the Girls Division. Sports Emporium, Lethal Weapon, and Napier all in first place. Bell in second place all by themselves. Femme Fatale and Adams in third. And rounding out that list, AD Pi, Delta Zeta, and BSU and FIMU rounding out the bottom. Okay, so softball playoffs will determine which two men's teams and which two women's teams will represent Georgia College at the state playoffs later this month. The Georgia College Colonials took to the diamond last Tuesday and handed Bruton Parker a 2-0 defeat behind the pitching of Kevin Dye and reliever Bill Shemp. The line score for that was Bruton Parker with no runs, three hits, and no errors. Georgia College had two runs, four hits, and no errors. The Colonials improved their record to 18-20. The Braves are back in action, and Central Georgia took its cameras out to find out how fans think they are going to do this season.
Do you think the Braves will do this year? Well, pitching staff does good. They go back to the World Series.
About for the year?
Yeah.
Oh, they're going to be in first play this year. Braves, yo. Oh, they need to get his stick going. Get his stick going, they'll be all right.
They're going to win.
They're going to win? Are they going to win the World Series?
Absolutely.
They're going to win the pennant.
I think the Braves have a good pitching staff this year. Bats are a little weak right now. By the time the end of the season rolls around, I think they'll pull it all together.
I guess we'll look at the action on the diamond for the true answer. That's all for sports this week. Back to you, Steve.
Hey, thanks a lot, Chris. When we come back, a trip to Warner Robins for a flying good time.
Here's one time it doesn't matter who your neighbor is. Here's the other. Life's too short. Stop the hate.
For years, men and women have taken to the skies to learn about flight, but now anyone can learn about the past of aviation right here in Central Georgia. The Warner Robins Museum of Aviation. What is it? I decided to spend a day there and see what it was all about. At the door, a visitor is met by volunteer worker Frank Cross, Jr., who tells you to sign in and where to go. The first stop was Hangar 1, where different eras of aviation are represented from early fighter planes to World War II bombers, all the way up to Operation Desert Storm. Oh yeah, did I mention the artwork on the planes? It wasn't bad either. Then it was on to the south end of the museum, which turned out to be even more interesting. It includes the P-51 Mustang, considered to be the best fighter plane during World War II. Along with it are early World War I planes, gliders, and the modern-day U.S. fighter jets, which some consider to be unbeatable by any foreign aircraft.
What we're looking at here is the tail end of an F-15 Eagle. Now, if we were really on a runway, this is not somewhere we'd want to be. So let's move along to the Museum of Aviation History.
Jim Belletto, director of artwork at the museum, and the one who is most responsible for the look of the museum, explains that much of aviation's history comes from Georgia.
Georgia history, people would be amazed how early aviation started off in Georgia, and that it was also probably responsible for pioneering aviation. Delta originated out of Georgia, Southern Airways, Epps Aviation, the early aircraft that you see here, and where you're standing in this whole room is all based on Georgia aviation in the early years when it first started out at the turn of the century, starting with the Epps brothers and working their way up. General Robert L. Scott, George Gay lives in Atlanta, who's the sole survivor of Midway. There's a lot of aviation history in Georgia, just people just don't realize.
Lance Jones, director of education of volunteers at the museum, also noted that the museum had some unique exhibits.
Well, we have several attractions. The Museum of Aviation is the home of the Hump Pilot Association, and we have the largest exhibit dedicated to hump pilot operations in the United States.
Okay, where is the hump?
We're in the hump pilot here, and that's dedicated to the men, women, and people of all nationalities that flew the logistics supply train over the hump, which was the Himalaya Mountains, from India to China, Burma, and other places in Asia. We also have the SR-71, which is a big attraction, the world's fastest airplane.
Okay. A few visitors said what they liked about the museum.
This aircraft over here, the Hilo, I used that during special operations over in the Gulf War.
I think over in the Hangar 1 building, I think I liked the trainer. They had a series of trainer aircraft lined up that were very interesting.
Even some kids from Northside Elementary had a personal museum favorite.
Sitting in the simulator, and it was like you're pretending to drive a airplane. That was probably my favorite part.
Oh, really? And if you go back, what are you going to tell your friends about the museum?
That it would be a real cool place to go if you're really into airplanes and if you're thinking about being in the Navy or in the Army.
What about the Air Force?
Air Force. Mm-hmm.
Well, I like the fields where all the airplanes are. You can see the different ones.
Yeah.
When we got to go in an airplane.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
That was pretty cool, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Really? Did you feel like you were really flying out there?
Well, what do you think of the museum?
Well, I liked it personally, but where do they get the money for the museum?
Museum of Aviation is a privately funded museum. All our money that we acquire is through private donations. Various institutions have gone in and donated large sums of money, such as Lockheed and some of the various aviation corporations, as well as local banks and things of that nature, as well as we had 10,000 students in the Houston County school system that donated their lunch money and raised over $10,000 to build the museum.
The day was about over, but not without a stop into the aviation shop, where you can choose from a large selection of t-shirts, towels, posters, books, and of course, models. As I began to leave, my buddy Frank, who had greeted me at the door, was busy with another couple. So I turned to Old Glory and thanked her for the memories, knowing that I'd be back to relive them one day soon. Steve Norris, Central Georgia Tonight.
The museum is conveniently located next to Robins Air Force Base in Warner Robins, Georgia. That's all the news tonight. Next week on Central Georgia Tonight, it's a Mudbug Festival celebrating springtime Louisiana style. Join us for a crawfish boil. Those stories and more of Central Georgia activities next week. Join us, won't you?